Hi guys, today we'll learn how to create purchase and sales ledgers and input and output tax ledgers. Now, based on the configuration in Ledger Master, the taxes will calculate automatically. We'll see how it will work. Here I have already created ledgers. To see already created ledgers, go to Accounts Info, Ledgers, Alter. Here I have created purchases. Purchase 5% under purchase account. Used in VAT returns, yes. And used for assessable value calculation, yes. And apportion for VAT method based on the value. So like this we have to create purchase 5% and sales 5% I have created already. Sales 5% under sales account, same, use for VAT return and use for assessable value calculation, yes. Apportion for VAT method based on the value, and I have created input VAT ledger as well. Input VAT here, input VAT at 5%. So we'll create input VAT against purchases. So here we are paying taxes, so we have to create against purchases input VAT 5% is under duties and taxes, and type of duty or tax. Here we'll get options. If you see here, VAT, and whether this is input or output, we'll select output for sales. This is for purchases input. VAT tax class, here this we have to select which percentage. So here 5%, and here also we have selected 5%, and normal rounding percentage 5% calculation. So based on this configuration, the tax will calculate automatically. So normal rounding and TDS not applicable, yes. And I have created output as well. If you see here, same duties and taxes, type of duty VAT, output. Here we'll get options whether output or input. Output VAT 5% and percentage 5 and VAT rate. How the system will calculate based on the VAT rate, the 5% normal rounding. And against this I have created vendors as well. If you see here, for our reference, I have created Vasant Trading Limited is a vendor. Sundry creditors, we have to pay him, and that is enough. And against sales also I have created ITC Limited is our customer under sundry debtors, current assets. Okay, we'll post the entries. Accounting vouchers, here first we'll post sales. So based on the bill, based on our invoice copy, we have to post here. So reference number will give our invoice number to, and party name here, sundry debtor ITC Limited is our customer. We are selling goods to the ITC Limited. Sales 5%, 5% amount 50,000. Output VAT 2,000. The tax will calculate automatically. If you see, 5% on 50,000, 2,500. The tax will calculate automatically. You need not to enter manually. Here again, invoice number. If you want, same thing being good sold to ITC Limited. Enter. And purchases, here we will get options for sales, the shortcut key for posting of vouchers F8, for purchases F9. Click on here, we will get option here. Here our vendor invoice number, and we bought goods from Vasant Trading Limited. Okay, the beside this I mentioned here vendor, this for a reference. Okay, select here purchase 5%, 40,000. Input VAT, tax will calculate automatically. Invoice number again 320 being material purchased from Vasant Trading Limited. Enter. Now we have posted sales and purchases. We'll see in P&L. Go to profit and loss account. Here we'll get, we have posted 40,000 purchases and sales 50,000. Okay. And we'll adjust against in output to input tax. So we'll get whether taxable or VAT payable or VAT net carry forward. So for that we have to create one more ledger. Go to accounts info, ledgers, create here VAT payable or will create VAT payable. So under due to send taxes, okay, others, you mentioned just others, every month we have to adjust against output to input. We'll see here, go to accounting voucher, go to JV, general, F7, press F7, here output VAT, how much, 2500. So here if you see here, before entering here, come back, output VAT will come. One second, I'll show you. Go to general, output VAT. If you see here, balance 2500 is there. Now we'll enter here 2500. If you see balance now, zero. Okay. Here input VAT, how much, 2000 rupees. Okay, and remaining VAT payable, this one. Like this, every month end we have to adjust against output VAT to input VAT. If output VAT is more than input VAT, we have to pay the tax. If input VAT is more than output VAT, that value will carry forward to next month. In next month we'll adjust against VAT payable. Okay, will here we have to pay VAT. So being VAT payable for the month of particular month. Month of April. Every month end we have to post this entry. If you see in balance sheet, current liabilities, duties and taxes, will get here VAT payable how much? 500 rupees. This we have to pay government. Okay, go to voucher, go to payment, F5. Here we'll get options F5. Here through we are paying HDFC bank VAT payable 500 rupees. See here balance is nullified, zero. Okay, being VAT paid for the month of April 14. Okay, we'll check in reports whether the balance is cleared or still it's showing in credit balance. Go to balance sheet and go to current liabilities. Here if you see duties and taxes, there is no value, nothing is there, we paid. So like that we have to create ledgers and input VAT tax ledgers, and we have to adjust output and input tax every month end. So thank you for watching. Thank you.